Good morning student, and today we are going to discuss chapter number 2, linear equation in one variable. Okay, so in this chapter we are going to solve exercise 2.1, question number 1. Solve the following equation. Question number 1 have x minus 2 is equal to 7. Okay, this is the question number 1, x minus 2 is equal to 7. In this question, we have solved this question several types. First type is step method, second type is you can transpose to left to right. Okay, so this is a left side and this is a right side. If you transpose to right side, so here you can see the in left side 2 is minus. Sine of 2 is minus, but when you transport it in right side, it becomes plus. So simply, if you transposing these two right side, then here in left side we have only 7 x, and right side we have 7, and after this we transpose 2 to right side, this is equal to plus. And we instantly find the value of x is 9. Okay. X is 9 is the solution of this equation. Also, you can find the solution of this equation or value of x by step methods. You can write adding to both sides. If you add to both sides, then you obtain x minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 7 minus plus 2. Because in just you say that adding to both sides. So we add here, this is left hand side, x minus 2 have, we have up this we add plus 2, and in right side we have 7 and we add 2. So you can see here x, this is minus 2 or this is plus 2, this is equal to 0. Then we have only x in the left hand side, but in right hand side 7 plus 2, this is equal to 9. So you can see in both method we find the value of x is 9. So I hope all of you understood how to find if any equation is given the value of variables. X is variables and 1, 2, 3 and so on is constant in the variables. Now second question of this exercise 2.1. Second question is y plus 3 is equal to 10. The equation is given. Question number 2. Y plus 3, this is equal to 10. Okay, so if you transpose this is left hand side, this is right hand side, and you transport 3 to left right side, then it become minus. Okay, or you can say subtracting 3 from both sides, then also you find the value of y, or you transpose this 3 to right hand sides. Okay, so you can see here, if you transport to this 3 to right hand side, so you have here y in the left hand side, and in right side we have 10. So if you transpose this 3 to right hand side, the sine of 3 in left hand side is plus, so it will become minus 3. So you can see this is equal to 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So y value of y is 7. This is solution of given equation. So y is equal to 7. You can say y is equal to 7 is the solution of given equation. Next question is question number 3. Question 3 have 6 is equal to z plus 2. Question number 3 have 6 is equal to z plus 2. So we can write it like this. We can change the left hand side to right hand side, or right hand side to left hand side. You can rotate it. So you can write it z plus 2 is equal to 6. Again we transpose these two to right hand side, then we have z is equal to 6 minus z is equal to, you can say this becomes the z is equal to 4 is the solution of the given equation 6 is equal to z plus 2. Now the next question, question number 4. What is the question number 4? You can see here. Question number 4 have 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 by 7. So this is a question number 4. This is equal to 3 by 7 plus x is equal to 17 by 7. This is a question number 4. Okay. So you can see actually variables 3 by 7 and 17 by 7 are constants. So we write constant one side and the variable other sides. Okay. So this method is called variable separable method also. So if you transfer this 3 by 7 to this side, if you transpose the 3 by 7 to right hand side, in left hand side we have x only, and right hand side we have 17 by 7, and it's become minus 3 by 7. Here you can see the sign of 3 by 7 is plus. When you transpose to right hand side, so sign of 3 by 7 becomes minus. Here it becomes minus. Okay, so you can see the both fractions have same denominator. Then you can subtract it very easy way. So the same of both fractions are 7. So 17 minus 3, this is equal to, you can say f is equal to 14. 17 minus 3 by 17 minus 3 is equal to 14 by 7, or you can say x is equal to 2. If you divide 14 by 7, then you obtain 2. So now next question number 5, 6x is equal to 12. Question is given here. Question number five. This is 6x is equal to 12. You can see here 6x is multiplied by 6. Okay, x is multiplied by 6. So we need to find value of x. So for this, you write variable one side and the constant other sides. But here you can see variable is left side and the constant is also left side. And this side only constant. So we transposing this constant to right hand side. Here you can see x is multiplied by 6. If you transpose 6, then 12 is divided by 6. Okay. So you can write it x is equal to 12 by 6. Then you obtain the value of x is equal to. If you divide 12 by 6, then you obtain 2. So student, I hope all of you understood how to find the value of x of such type given questions. In other methods, you can find the value of x like this. If this is given, x is equal to 12. So you can divide both sides by 6, because you can see here the x is multiplied by 6. So you write here dividing both sides by 6. If you divide both sides by 6, then you also obtain the value of x 6 expansive. Here when you divide 12 by 6, then you obtain 2. So in both methods you find the value of x is 2. So both are true. Okay. Now the question number 6. In question number 6, t by 5 is equal to 12. T by 5 is equal to, this is given 10. We need to find the value of t. We need to find the value of t. Here you can see t divided by 5. Okay, the result is equal to 10. So you can transpose the 5 and right hand side. Here 5 divides t. If you transpose 5 to right side, this 5 multiply by 10. Okay, so now t is equal to becomes 10 into 5. Okay, we transpose this 5 and to a right hand side. Here you can see 5 is divided to 10 t. When we transpose this 5 to right hand sides, it's multiplied by 10. Okay, so the value of t is equal to 10 5 the 15. Okay, t is equal to 5 is the solution of, you can say t is equal to 50 is the solution of given equation. What is our equation? T by our equation is t by 5 is equal to 10. Now next question, question number 7. What is question number 7? 2 by 3x in is equal to 18. Question number 7 is 2 by 3x is equal to 18. Okay, so you can see here 2 by 3 multiplied by x, or you can say x is multiplied by 2 by 3. When you transpose to left right side, then 2 by 3 divide 18 is divided by 2 by 3. Okay, so firstly you can transpose only 3, 2x is equal to 18 into 3. Okay, 3 divide 2x is divided by 3, then we first transpose 3 to right hand side, then we have seen here the 3 multiplied by 18. Okay, 18 multiplied by 3. After this in left hand side, you can see here 2 in 2x, 2x is equal to 2 into x. It means that x is multiplied by 2. If x is multiplied by 2, so we transfer this to right hand side, because we separate the variable one side and the constant other side. So here we can write here x is equal to 18 into 3 by 2. And x is equal to, we can write here, if you divide 18 by 2, we have 9 into 3. So x is equal to 9 into 3 is equal to 27. So value of x is 27, or you can say and the 27, x is equal to 27 is the solution of given equation. Okay, now question number 8. Question number 8 is equal to 1.6. Question number 8 have 1.6 is equal to y by 1.5. This is question number 8 is equal to 1.6 is equal to 1.6 is equal to y by 1.5. And you can write it y by 1.5, this is equal to 1.6, or y is equal to 1.6 into 1.5. Okay, because here you can see y is divided by 1.6. when you transpose 1.5 here in this question, y is divided by 1.5 and in right side 1.6. so we write variable one side and constant other sides. Okay, so for this we transposing 1.5 to right sides. Okay, so if you transpose 1.5 right sides, here y divided by 1.5, and when you transpose this right side, then we obtain that 1.6 is multiplied by 1.5. so what is the product of 1.6 into 1.5? how you find? If you multiply like this, 1.6 into 1.5, this becomes 15, 15, 16, 19. Carry 1, 15 into 15, 15 plus 19, 24. Okay, 24. So digit after 2 decimal, one digit here, one digit here. Okay, this becomes 2.40. This becomes 2.40. Okay, so value of y is equal to 2.40. So student, I hope all of you understood this question, how to solve if the given equation, and then we find the value of equations, or you can say the value of variables. Okay, with transposing the casting other sides and variable one side casting other side. In this way, we find the value of variables. Now, next question number 9, 7x minus 9 is equal to 16. So let's see how to solve this question. So 1x minus 9, question number 9, this is equal to 7x minus 9, this is equal to 16, okay, 7x minus 9, this is equal to 16, and this is our given equation. You need to find the value of x, or you can say the value of equation, okay. How can you find? First we transpose variable one side and cancel the other side. See, here you can see only one variable here, x is variable, 16 is constant, 9 is constant, and 7 is also constant. So first we transfer this minus 9 to right hand side. When we transfer this minus 9 to right hand side, x become plus 9, okay. So let's see, first we transfer this 9 to right hand side. So you have only in left hand side 7x, because we transposing this minus 9 to right hand side, x become 16 right iot, this is plus 9, okay. So 7x, this is equal to 16 plus 9, 16 plus 9 is 25, this is equal to 25. Now 7x is equal to 25, but 7 is constant, so again we transposing this 7 to right hand side. Here in left hand side you can see x is multiplied by 7, so when we transpose 7 to right hand side, then we obtain 25 divided by 7. So x is equal to 25 by 7. This is equal to 25 by 7 is the solution of the given equations. Now we are going to solve next question. Now next question, question number 10. Question number 10 have 14y minus 8 is equal to 13. 14y minus 10, minus 8 is equal to 13. This is given, this is the questions, okay. This is our equations, 14y minus 8 is equal to 10. We need to find here the value of y. How we find the value of y? First we transpose minus 8 to right hand side, okay. We use separator separation of variable methods. In this methods we write variable one side and constant other side. So what is constant here? 13 is constant, 8 is constant, minus 8 is constant, and 14 is constant, and y is only one variable here, okay. So first we transposing minus 8 to right hand side, okay. Our aim to find the value of y, okay. For this we separate the variable and the constant. We write constant one side and variable other sides, okay. So first we separate this constant and transposing minus 8 to right hand side, it become plus 8, okay. So we can write 14 in left hand side. We can write 14y is equal to 13 plus 8, okay. So y, 14y means y into 14 into y. 14y means y into 14, and in right hand side 13 plus 8, this is equal to 21. 13 plus 8, this is equal to 21. Here we separate the variable one side and the constant other side, but in left hand side you can see y is constant, y is variable, and 14 is constant, and right hand side, so 21 is also constant. So we transposing this 14 to right hand side, so then you have in left hand side, this is y Here you can see in left hand side y is multiplied by 14. When transpose this 14 to right hand side, then we obtain 21 is divided by 14. 21 is divided by 14. So here you can see, if you simplify this, so you can write 21 is 3 into 7, and 14, if you break in the product of prime factor, then you obtain 14 is equal to 2 into 7. So 7, 7 is cancelled because 7 is common between both numerator and denominator. 7 is common between numerator and denominator, so it will be cancelled, and we have only 3 by 2. So you can say 3 y is equal to 3 by 2. Y is equal to 3 by 2 is the solution of the given equations. Okay. In such equation, we separate variable one side and constant other side. Now, so in this way, I hope all of you understood how to find the value of y in this equation. Y 14y minus 8 is equal to 13. So you solve it and you find it, the value of y is 3 by 2. Now, we are going to discuss next question, question number 11. 11 has 17 plus 6p is equal to 9. Okay, question number 11. Question number 11 higher 17 plus 6p is equal to 9. In this question, we need to find the value of p. So how we find the value of p? For this, we separate variable one side and the constant other sides. What is the variable here? Only p is the variable. And what is the constant? Here in this question equations, 9 is constant, 6 is constant, and 17 is constant. So first we separate constant right hand side, and we write variable left side. So first we transfer this 17 to right hand side. So here you can see 17 in the 17 constant 17 with positive sign. When you transfer this 17 and to right hand side, it become negative. So we have only 6p in left hand side, and we write here 9 as it is in right hand side. But when we transpose in 17, so it become minus 17. Okay, we transpose in 17 to right hand side, it become minus 17. So we can write 6p means 6 into 2. Okay, so minus 9. 9 minus 17, that we subtract 9 from 17 and we use the symbol of greater numbers. So here 17 is greater numbers. Okay, and so we have 8. Okay, 6p is equal to minus 8, or you can write it, if you transfer this 6 to right hand side, then we have in left hand side only p, and minus 8 is divided by this 6, because p is multiplied by 6. When you transpose 6 to right hand side, we obtain that minus 8 is divided by 6. So simply you can write minus 4, minus 8 is 4 into 2, and 6 is 3 into 2. You can see here in numerator and denominators have two common, so we can cancel two. Then we have the value of p minus 4 by 3. Okay, so you can say that the minus 4 by 3 is the solution of given equation, or you can also say that the value of p is minus 4 by 3. Now we are going to discuss next question, question number 12. This is last question of this exercise 2.1. Okay, so question number 10 has 3x by 3 plus 1 is equal to 7 by 25. So let's see how to solve question number 12. X by 3, question number 12, this is equal to x by 3 plus 1 and this is equal to 7 by 15. 7 by 15. Okay. So in this questions, we need to find the value of x. For this, we use variable separable method. In this method, we write variable one side and constant other side. So what is variable in this questions? Variable is x and constant is 1. 7 by 15 is constant, 3 is constant. Okay, so we separate constant, we transposing constant right hand side 1 by 1. So first we transposing this one to right hand sides. Okay, when you transpose this one, you can see here 1 in left hand side with positive sign. If you transpose this one in right hand side, it's become negative sign. Okay, so you can write x by 3 is equal to 7 by 15 here minus 1. Okay, this is minus 1. So in left hand side you can write x by 3 as it is. So here minus 1, 7 by 15, you can write is equal to minus 1 by minus 1. So what is the LCM? LCM is 15, you can write here. And 15 on the 15, 7 on the 7, minus 1 into 15, 15, again 15 on the 15. Here you are often 15. So you can see when you subtract 7 minus 15, then you obtain 8, it is equal to minus 8 by 15. And you can write here minus x by 3 is equal to minus 8 by 15. Or if you transfer this 3 to right hand side, in this left hand side you can see the x is divided by 3. When you transferring the this 3 on right hand side, so minus 8 by 15 is multiplied by 3, because in left hand side x is divided by 3. So you can write here x is equal to minus 8 by 15 into 3, or you can write minus 8 as it is, but 15 you can write 3 into 5 into 3. 3 is cancelled. Then the value of x is equal to minus 8 by 5. If you change it in improper fraction, this is improper fraction, you can write it in the mixed fraction like this. This is equal to minus 5 on the 5, 5 plus 3, 8, minus 1 whole, minus 1 whole. 3 by 5. Okay, so in this way you find the value of x is equal to minus 8 by 5, or you can write it in the mixed fraction, x is equal to minus 1 whole 3 by 5. So student, I hope all have understood these questions. Okay, now the next question is that x by 3 and plus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 3 by 2. We need to find the value of x. And how we find the value of x? Or you can see the equation of solution of the given equation. When you separate variable one side and the constant one other side, then you find the solution of this equation. Okay. So for this, we transferring this 5 by 2 to right hand sides. Okay, so when we have here x by 3 is equal to 3 by 2, we write as it is. When transferring 5 by 2 in right hand side, then we have this becomes minus 5 by 2. Okay, so x by 3, this is equal to, if take LCM 2, we have minus 3, minus 5. Minus 3 and minus 5, this is equal to minus 8 by 2. If you divide minus 8 by 2. In left hand side we have only x by 3, it become minus 4. You can see in left hand side x is divided by 3. When you transposing to 3 in right hand side, minus 4 is multiplied by 3. And so you can write here x is equal to minus 4 into 3, or x is equal to minus 12. The x square to minus 12 is the solution of a given equation. What is the equation? X by 3 plus 5 by 2 is equal to minus 3 by 2. This is given equation. When you solve it, we find the x is equal to minus 12. X is equal to minus 12 is the solution of the given equations. So student, I hope all of you understood and you are able to find the solution of any equations. Okay. So I think this is enough for you. And thank you for watching. Jai Hind.